title came again, and the title is Victory Over the Spirit of the Night. Victory Over the Spirit of the Night. Night, night, night. You know they call night, N-I-G-H-T, when it's dark. All right, so we're looking into that teaching this morning, Victory Over the Spirit of the Night. It's a series I've been making, and I believe the Holy Ghost wants to share certain deep things with you, and I'm going to share with you how certain mysteries deep from the Holy Spirit, and how these mysteries will help you, and how these mysteries will keep you facing the realities. But in everything, Christ has already delivered us. The blood of Jesus speaks of better things. The blood of Jesus is more powerful. The blood of Jesus has more authority. Yet we find that the night has its own reason. Before we go there, let me read the commentary. There's something, yesterday's commentary in the evening, I didn't take note of that, but I want to read it because there's something that that came into my mind. It says, Psalm 74, verse 16. Psalm 74, verse 16. I got to record this on the conference line so that most of you can adapt that, and so we can get into that later on if you want to listen to it, and you can have the opportunity to do that. Psalm 74, verses 16. Psalm 74, verses 16. In fact, let's look at that scripture in the Bible, and let's try to read, see if we can read more of it, and to have a great understanding. You see in the scripture of the Psalm that God is contrasting two things. There's a contrast here, right? Let's read from verse. From verse 3, lift up thy feet unto the perpetual desolations, even all that the enemy had done wickedly in the sanctuary. It's talking about in Psalm 74, verse 3. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Let me from verse 1, Psalm 74, verse 1. So you have a full understanding of what is contrasting the power of God and wickedness and what is going on in society. And the psalmist predicting certain things. By the Holy Spirit, is speaking to the future and the present. O God, why hast thou cast us off forever? Why doth thine anger smoke against the sheep of thy pasture? Now, sheep can't stand smoke. One of the weaknesses of sheep is smoke. When there's a smoke and you put sheep in there, the sheep will act as though they're going mad. Remember thy congregation which thou hast purchased of old. Remember the congregation which thou hast purchased of old. It means God's children are paid for. We're going deeper into the mystery of this psalm this morning. The people of God, you as a child of God, you've been paid for. Purchase means someone owned you, so you belong to somebody. Someone paid the price for you. Someone has met the demand, and you've been ransomed. You've been paid for. When Jesus came into the world and he died at the cross, he paid for our ransom. We were purchased by the blood of Jesus. That was the price. That was the cost. That's how much it cost God. That's what it cost him. God doesn't operate with your currency. Your currency is not a world currency. So if you're going to go to any nation, they have their own currencies. But God purchased with the whole universal currency, that currency of redemption, which is the blood of Jesus. He says, remember thy congregation, which you have purchased of old, the rod of thine inheritance, which thou hast redeemed, which thou hast redeemed, this Mount Zion, wherein thou hast dwelt. Lift up thy feet unto the perpetual desolations, even all that the enemy had done wickedly in the sanctuary. It means in the sanctuary there's pollution. In the sanctuary there's contamination. In the church there's wickedness. Among the people of God there's ungodliness. It means pollution means something that was once pure has been contaminated. It means the powers of darkness, the kingdom of the night, has penetrated light. Now, I'm going to stop there because I'm going to continue. And it seems, if you look all around you, all around the situation that surrounds humanity, it seems there's no need for godliness. It seems Christianity or the gospel has become a weak of the weakest link. So you think. And you might even argue that carnal reasoning, why is God allowing this? So you have said. You might have even said, oh, why did God not do this? Why? So you assume. All right, yes, you assume because you read God created the heavens and the earth. The earth belongs to God, so God has power. And God can just come in and manipulate mankind. But you forgot that God does not operate like that. That you and I, we are creatures of our free will. Now, the most interesting thing is this. How come that the kingdom of darkness is often attractive to mankind than the kingdom of light? Well, God said it. Man loves evil. Man is attracted to evil. That is man's default nature. Man operates in that default realm of life. Man enjoys it. Man enjoys when there's evil, when there's wickedness. It seems most people flourish in that. Why? Because the heart of a man is wicked. That place where man becomes himself, the heart of a man is desperately wicked. Oh boy, I know you say, but Pastor, I don't think, oh yes, your heart is wicked, baby. My God, if your heart will have your way, you can do worse. The powers of the mind seems to be attractive in the heart because the heart is hidden from the human eye. Therefore, darkness is hidden. Darkness loves hidden place. Darkness dwells in hidden environment, hidden corners. You don't teach a child to be afraid. The child grows up to assume that because there's a hidden corner in the house, something is locking behind that. That there's this mindset that in the dark, there's evil. In the dark, there's evil. Now, there's a mystery. Because when God created the heavens and the earth in the first day, you discover that God made the night to rule in the evening, and the day to rule in the daytime. The light to rule the day, and the night to rule the evening. Well, if there's a rulership, then there are powers. There are authority, there are dominions, there are places of influence. These are powers that govern the environment, the atmosphere, the earth, and the humans in the earth. But in the beginning, it was not so. You know the story how Adam fell? When Adam fell, Adam did not just succumb to sin. When Adam fell, Adam succumbed to the power of the night. When Adam fell, Adam succumbed to the power of wickedness. His heart became wicked. And every man that has been born of a woman inherited that wickedness in his heart on his own. The heart is desperately wicked. The heart is wicked and filled with all kind because it's in the dark. It's in the dark. It's darkness in the heart. When darkness is in the heart and there's no light in that heart, the heart produces wickedness. It is ruled by the night. All right. Pollution. Pollution. What was once a beautiful place has become a dissolution, a desolate place, a wasted land, a wasted destiny, a wasted family, a wasted glory, a wasted calling. How? Because of the powers of the night. Jesus even said something. He said, while men were sleeping, the enemy comes to sow his seed at night. But when the guy was the farmer or the owner of the vineyard was busy doing it in the daytime, the enemy was observing. But at night, while men slept, at night, it means the enemy has his own territory. The enemy has his own legal boundaries. The enemy knows when it is time to conduct its own orchestra in the people on the face of the earth. So the enemy utilizes its own dispensed grace to do what he wants to do at night. For if the enemy operates in the day, it will be hard for him to be combated, right? Well, don't get me wrong, the enemy operates in the day in certain levels, but the powers of darkness reveals themselves at night. The night watch is their domain. Their night watch is their territory. And often what they do at night lingers through the day. The havoc they create at night often continues in the daytime, because what has been sown in the night must bring forth fruit in the day. It needs the light to manifest. The light manifests the gross wickedness. Darkness covers wickedness, but light exposes wickedness. That is why your heart needs the light of God. The word of God is a light. That word is a light and a lamp unto my feet. It's a light. God's word is not night. God's word is not darkness. God's word is light. When the light of the word of God comes into your inner man, has access into your home, when the light has access into your being, it changes your heart. It causes your heart to lose its sting and passion for wickedness. Oh, someone hear the word of God this morning. Overcoming the spirit of the night. Overcoming the spirit of the night. Oh yes, at that night watch, all kinds of uncleanness, all kinds of wickedness, all kinds of ungodliness, all kinds of demonic manifestation manifest itself in the night. Have you wondered, or have you been perplexed, why during the night you have all kinds of strange dreams, all kinds of attack, all kinds of... Because it is their era, that is their watch, that is their dimension, that is when it unfolds, when your body is being submissive to the powers of the night. So the psalmist prayed. He says, Lord, lift up thy feet. Why? The feet of God is a light. When God's feet is lifted up over us, light comes upon you. Lift up thy feet. Let your light come up. Give us light in this darkness. Give us light. You are going to pray, oh God, lift up your feet. Lift up thy feet unto thy perpetual desolation. Lift up your feet. My God, put an end to the powers of the night in my life. Put an end to the powers of the night in my marriage. Put an end to the powers of the night in my family. Put an end to the powers of the night in my business. Put an end to the powers of the night over my career. So I'll talk to God this morning. I want you to pray. Father, in the name of the Lord Jesus, lift up thy feet, O God. Lift up thy feet. Arise. When God lifts up his feet, he's risen. He arises over your situation. Light comes over that circumstance. We come against every power of the night that has laid our desolation, perpetual waste, that has desolated our habitation. We come against the powers of the night that has stirred up itself to encroach into our light, into our space. Oh God, raise up thy feet, my Lord and my rock. This season, oh God, as a new season begins, as a new arrangement in the heavens begins, grant us victory. Grant over the powers of the night. The Bible has so much to say about the night, and we're going to go through scriptures about the night. About the night. Victory over the spirit of the night. Over the spirit. I think it baffles me. There are certain areas during the day I can walk alone, excited, happy. But when it's night, you feel that someone is there. You feel that there's a presence at that night. You feel that danger is around the corner. How come during the day you can walk freely in that area? But when it comes at night, even your senses begins to signal you that something is not right. What are you doing in this neighborhood alone in the night? This is the wrong place to be in the night. But yet there are people that enjoy the night. There are people whose heart have grown. They need to harvest what has been sown, that wickedness over their being. They love the night watch. They get up at night to do evil. The purpose in their heart, this is the night. They're excited at night. In the daytime, they are sleeping. No, at night, they rise up. It says, no, this night is good. We have to act on this night. We can do something with this night. It means there are certain powers that lurk at night. There are certain spirits that seek to ruin destinies at night. There are certain stars. When those stars manifest, the zodiac belt, the zodiac sign in the heavens. When I talk about zodiac, you are confused now. Well, don't be confused, because often most Christians don't know the main mystery of zodiac. It's in the Bible. Oh yes, the occultic world and the wicked world have confused it. And I told you they love to steal. And so they steal the parts of the stars. The arrangement patterns of the stars called the zodiac patterns. And certain people are born wicked. Certain people are seeds of darkness. Certain people, when I say darkness, I mean the night. Darkness and night is the same thing. It's like day and light. Synonyms. Darkness and night is the same thing. So Jesus says, if your heart, your light, your eyes is dark, how great is your darkness? It means there's something that takes over their vision, that takes over their perception. So they operate at night. Do you know that there are certain animals, they do well at night? It baffles me that an animal can run in the thick forest with no cut-out path. Hello? And the animal will not hit the tree. Have you observed that? That those animals that dwell in the jungles and the thick forest, they can run and there are trees everywhere and they don't hit the trees. You try to run at night in the forest. Because you are not adapted to rule at night. You are not adapted to navigate at night. But there are creatures that are habitual creatures of the night. And let me read something again, because I'm building up on a series. Victory over the spirit of the night. And I believe God, by the end of this prayer season, of these teachings, you will overcome every pass of the night over your life. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, you overcome the power of fear, the power of demonic oppression, the power of demonic torment, the powers of frustration, the powers of defeat, the power of helplessness, the powers of hopelessness, the powers of rejection, the powers of chaos, the powers of disorderliness. Because these are the spirit of the night. Darkness. The spirit of the night. The spirit of the night. The spirit of the night. Now let's read on. Even all that the enemy had done wickedly in the sanctuary. Psalm 74 verse 3. What has the enemy done in the sanctuary? Night and darkness are not friends. night and day. Night and darkness is the same thing, right? No. Night, hear me. Night and day are not friends. They don't cohabit. Hello? They are not friends. The day exposes the night. The night conceals. The day exposes. But the day or light is more powerful than the night. That's how God has ordained it. But the night is very aggressive than the day. Somebody hear what I'm saying? The night is much more aggressive than the day. The night is very, very aggressive than the day. The night is so much more aggressive than the day. Have you seen a wicked man, a wicked woman in oppression? Let me explain something to you. Go to Genesis chapter 1, verse 5. I want to explain certain things so that we have an understanding of what I'm trying to say tonight. You're coming to a full understanding of what I'm teaching tonight, or this morning, or whatever time is your time over there, whatever time you're watching this broadcast, so that you come into a full understanding of what I'm teaching. You come to a full revelation of the powers of God and what God can do. The whole earth is created by God. God has dominion over every power. God has dominion over everything. God reigns supreme. God rules over the universe. God is sovereign. God has dominion over everything. Everything that man can think or reason, God has dominion. God has dominion over the powers of darkness. God has dominion over the kingdom of darkness. God is great. God is awesome. God is wonderful. And God cannot fail. And God cannot lie. God is a reality. And God is a reality. And God is a great God. Look at scripture. Genesis chapter 1, verse 5. We're going to go back to Psalm 74. I want to contrast certain things with you. And God called the light day, and the darkness he called night. And the evening and the morning were the first day. All right, if you read Genesis chapter 1, let's go there. Let me read Genesis chapter 1. Let's look at Genesis chapter 1 so you have a view. In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. Verse 2. Now that's what you need to understand the mystery here. When God created the heavens and the earth, it says the earth was without form and void. The earth was without form and void. There was an emptiness. It has no order. It has no shape. It has nothing. But there was something there. There was something in that chaos. There was a presence already there. And darkness was upon the face of the deep, not light. Darkness was already existed, or was already in existence on the earth before light was called out. Because before light was introduced, light was introduced to subdue the darkness. Light was introduced to put the darkness where it belongs. The whole earth was void. There were two things. I'm going to go deep here. There were two things. Two things that the Bible did not reveal their essence, meaning their beginning point in life, in creation. God created everything. There's nothing in the universe that God did not create. But when God created the earth, when God created the heaven and the earth, there was something on the earth already when it has existed for nobody knows how long, before God now said, okay, let me come back and do some work on the earth. Yeah, the mystery here. The two things are two places of power and principalities of oppression in the universe today. They've not changed. They're abode. They've not changed their location. Before God created the earth, when God said, let us create the earth, I want to create the air, the earth, the heavens, and the earth. Look at verse 2. And the earth was without form. Now on the earth, the heaven was already made. And the earth, God created the heavens and the earth. And now it says, the earth, this place, this present place, this present realm, this present reality was without form. Yet there were two powers already dominating it. In that place of void, in that place of, when you say something is void, it means the transaction is rendered, it didn't go through, it's useless, it's waste, it's of no use. Void, you can't use it. It is of no beneficiary thing to you. It's of no use. If I give you a void check means it is canceled, you can't catch it. Although I might put $1 billion in it and across I say void, but you ain't paying, you're not going to get paid that check. Makes no difference. Even if $1 billion is in the bank and I refuse to sign my signature on that check and I just wrote void, they're not going to give you that money. At least in America, they won't give you the money. Maybe in another country, they might give you the money. Void. It was without form and void. Yet there was a presence in that void. There was a presence without that form. There was a power ruling that place. It was the powers of the waters and darkness. So you have the marine kingdom, the spirit of the water world, and then the powers of darkness, conniving, one entity. And these are fallen demons. Powers that rebelled against God's authority. Angels that lost their position in heaven. Habiting the waters. Habiting darkness. All they used to, they once knew God's light. But now they're in darkness because out of God's presence is darkness. You got to get that. Outside of God's presence, all that is left is darkness. Yes, you may be alive. You may be on the earth. I agree with you. You see light, you see day, you see night, you see. But outside of God, there's darkness in your heart. There's darkness in your understanding. There's darkness in your lifestyle. There is darkness in your functioning. Outside of God, there is darkness. All you have is darkness occupied by demonic spirit, occupation of unclean spirit in your mind, in your heart. That's why a life without Christ is darkened already. A heart without Jesus Christ has no light. There's no peace. There's no joy. Don't confuse joy with a merry heart, because you can create artificial joy through alcohol, sexual addiction, entertainment. It just entertains your senses. But don't forget, it does not sustain your spirit, man. So all this thing in the world is of no use to you. It doesn't satisfy you. I know you are saying, well, when I get them, I will know how to use it. Others have said that before you. Millions of people in the world have tried it. They've all failed. So you're not going to be the first to break the rule. You're still a man. You're still a human, flesh and blood. Without Christ, without the life of God. Now I'm talking to those of you that are not born again, that might watch this broadcast in the future on the YouTube or wherever you watch it, and you just flipped on it and you go, what is he saying? It means you need to give your heart to Jesus. It means you need to get out of darkness and come into the light. It means you need to be free from the spirit of the night. In hell, the only light there is the fire of hell. Hell is a pitch dark place. It's just like the volcano. You see the volcano flame, that's what you're going to be seeing over there. In fact, the volcano is a prototype of hell. It comes from deep the earth, underneath the earth. Hell is a physical destination. Imagine a place where the volcano fires are coming up, the flames are coming up from. I mean, it's a mystery, right? That the whole creation, there's fire underneath the earth. You're on top of the earth, it's cool. But there's fire underneath the earth. There's fire underneath the earth. It's amazing. So the whole creation says there's a witness of what God can do. And darkness was upon the face of the deep. Darkness ruled the deep. There was water. There was deep. There was a deep darkness. It was a void. It was a hollow darkness. And God said, let there be light. God said, let there be light. Why? Because it's light is from God. Light is from God. Light is more powerful. When you are in the light, oh, you have more power than the powers of darkness. When you are in the light, yes, on this earth there's wickedness. Yes, on this earth, the children of darkness are numerous. It's a fact. The sons and daughters of darkness are more in population than the children of light. That is the truth. That's the state of creation. It has always been like that. It has always been so. In the days of Noah, there were more dark hearts, wicked hearts than Noah. Only eight men, only eight people were saved from the first flood. In Sodom and Gomorrah, oh yes, soon they're going to abolish that word Sodom and Gomorrah from the Bible. Oh yes. So the world wants to, you know, the world wants to get you into so many things, and the world wants to get you believing so many stuff. Yes. Sodom and Gomorrah. 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 Only Lot. Only three people were spared out of darkness. So the whole world is under darkness. Yet light is more powerful than darkness. And God said, let there be light. Let there be light. And God said, let there be light. And there was light. Light is from God. It is the Spirit of God coming over darkness to separate it and cause His presence to shine. So light came. Light. Church, light. 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 And God saw the light that it was good. The darkness was not good. God did not see darkness as good. God never saw darkness as good. God saw the light that the light was good. It was the light that was good, church, not darkness. It was the light that was good. God saw the light. God saw that the light was good. God saw that the light was good. Hallelujah. Oh my God. God saw that the light was good. The light was good. And God divided the light from the darkness. God divided the light. God always divides. Oh, yes. God is a God that divides. He's a divider. He separates things. Hallelujah. Woo! And God divided the light from the darkness. God separated them and says, hey, hey, you are two separate things. You cannot mix. You cannot work together. You cannot relate together. Yeah. You are the contrast. You are opposite of each other. You are not meant to be fellowshipping with each other. You are not meant to relate. What are you doing? Getting yoked with people of darkness. What are you doing? Getting friendship with folks of darkness. What are you appreciating? You are going to pray. Everywhere that I've been initiated into darkness. Everywhere that my offspring has been shed into the paths of darkness, everywhere, knowingly or unknowingly, that I in my own self has been held back. bound by darkness. Oh God, divide by your word. Send for that word that brought division between light and darkness. Separate me, my Lord, and my rock. I cry out to you this morning that God, I'll be separated. I cry out to you today that I'll be separated from everything of darkness in my father's house, in my foundation, from my mother's womb. You God that knew me, separate. Somebody pray. This is your deliverance this morning. This is your deliverance prayer point this morning. You getting delivered from that womb of darkness. Listen. You are going to pray. Hold on. I don't know if you've seen that movie. It's called Spiritual Challenge. I will advertise it for you. It's free. It's on YouTube. You just type Spiritual Challenge. It's those Nigerian movies. I told you Nigerians, when they do their movies, they don't know how to write fantasies. Every Nigerian movie is a reality of a truth. Nigeria, or like India, Bollywood or Nollywood, how they call it. These guys, they don't know how to write, they don't know how to entertain you. They try to bring reality. What they knew, what they've done, what they've heard, what is the norm of the culture, and bring it into you as just to make you aware. They seek to bring awareness to you. It's their form of teaching you, listen, these things are real. Growing up in that culture, I've got the opportunity to see things happen and yet things happen, witness things happen. So when I try to say certain things, they are either based from the culture we're coming from, or what we've heard, what we've learned, what we've seen, what we've discovered as a reality and a way of life. Years ago, that whole continent was in darkness. It was in steep darkness. Under 100 years now, light is penetrating. Light has not taken over, but light is still penetrating. And there's something interesting in that movie that I want to bring to your attention. Spiritual Challenge. It's on YouTube. Those movies take hours. They have part one, they have part two, but a very interesting movie. Let me give you the summary. Yeah, you have this man, he's old, he's married, he's been married for 12 years, he needs the fruit of the womb. It needs a child. I'm talking to somebody on the line because that is you. That is you. You might say, well, Pastor Apostle Williams, I might not know. Well, no. I'm talking about you. That is you. And so the wife believes in God. The wife believes in prayer. And she believes that God is able to give them child or children. And she's waited. But the man doesn't want to wait. He's getting old. People are laughing at him, but he's very wealthy and he's in the occult. It's in a secret society, what you call the occult. And in this occultic group, he's worshiping a strange demonic god. But he comes to the church. So because he goes to church with his wife he married, who's a Christian, this demonic deity is angry with him. And he goes to the meeting, the occultic meeting at night, because they function in darkness. So he goes to the occultic meeting at night, and they told him, the high priest, they have a pastor too, they have a high priest. And the high priest told them, said, listen, the reason you're barren is because you're going to church. This old deity is not happy with you going to church. So what he wants to do is to stop going to church and you're going to get pregnant. And you're going to have a boy. And you're going to have a boy. And by the time that boy is 23 years old, you must initiate that boy to this occult, to this covenant. It's a must. And they ask him to swear that if he doesn't do that, he's going to die. That if he doesn't bring the child when the child is 23 years old, he's going to die. Very interesting. And yet he goes. He stopped going to church. The wife is praying for Reverend Father, goes to prayer meeting to have a child. And soon the child, the wife got pregnant. The lady had a dream. In that dream, someone was dragging a baby from her, and she woke up. And the husband said, "Don't worry, don't worry, don't worry, you're gonna have a child." And so, for real, she has a child, and she has this child, boy. She's got this child, and he's, "Hey, I've got this child, I've got this child." And she takes the child to church, dedicates the child, but the husband doesn't go to church anymore. Whenever he wants to go to church, he will give an excuse, "I have this business deal." And the child grows, and the child says he wants to become a pastor. He wants to go to seminary. But the father said, "I'm going to kill the woman." He says, "I'm going to kill you. My only son wants to go." But figure the story out. I want you to watch it. I won't tell you all the story. Now I've created, now I know you'll be interested. You're going to watch it. All right? So watch it, and we'll talk more. Let's go to the Word of God today. I just want to spite you. You cannot get anything from darkness and go free. Darkness destroys itself. Nothing grows in darkness. No plant grows in darkness. Nothing functions in darkness except evil and wickedness. Darkness symbolizes destruction. The night symbolizes destruction. It symbolizes ruin. It symbolizes defeat and chaos. As a child of God, God is still in control of the night over his children. God protects his children at night. God caused them to have good sleep at night. God caused them to have rest at night, because that is God's duty. He still controls the night. All powers in heaven and earth belongs to God. He has not changed. So you don't have to be afraid of the night. But you must come out of the night. You must come out of darkness for God to help you. The two powers that has dominated creation and everything created by God on the earth is the water spirit, what we call marine kingdom, and the kingdom of darkness. They work hand in hand. In the beginning, there was water and there was darkness before there was light. Let me repeat again. There was water, first of all. The whole earth was covered with water, and it was dark before God started creating. It means these are elements, those powers that God cast out of heaven. They were falling into these mediums. They occupied this territory as a place of life. Spirits are not meant to occupy void. Spirit do not occupy void. Spirit don't occupy an empty space. Spirit occupy things and substance and mediums and whatever. Darkness is not the void. You can feel darkness. You can sense darkness. You can... You are going to pray. Every darkness in your foundation. Oh, yes. I said every darkness in your foundation. You wonder. All kinds of things that happens to you in the spirit world. All kinds of strange dreams, strange association, and you can't even tell. But you love God. It's because there's darkness in you and there's light in you, and God wants the light to win. And God wants to set you free. You are going to begin to pray. If your father was not born again before you were born, if your father did not truly know what Jesus is or filled with the Holy Spirit, there's 101 possibility that there's part darkness in your being. I'm talking to someone on this line this morning. See, it's only the truth that sets you free. So Jesus says, and you know the truth. The truth is light. The truth enlightens you. The truth gives you light. The truth gives you light. The truth equips you. The truth enables you. The truth gives you light. I think, when I give my life to Christ, I give my life, I say, "Jesus, come into my life." Have you got deliverance? What is deliverance now? We're sorry. Things don't just go like that. What is deliverance? Do I read my Bible every day? Sorry, that's not what I'm talking about. Well, we don't believe in deliverance. Our church don't believe in deliverance. Our denomination don't believe in it. We believe one save every day, save everybody, save. Well, congratulations, it is your life. You're the one dealing with the issues, right? In Psalm 74, it says the sanctuary has been polluted by strange teachings, by strange spirits, by strange individuals who claim to be something that they are not, and they want to tell you that there's no need for it. Oh, yes, because hey, every man comes from a culture, from a knowledge base. What they're not exposed to, how can they know of it? What they've not dealt with, how can they understand the fullness of it? It's like you telling someone that has never seen poverty that people are poor. All his life he's lived in a palace. All his life he's lived within the courtyard of the kingdom. And then he goes out as a full old man. He has never seen poverty. He has never seen people beg. He has never seen people sleeping on the street. All of a sudden he gets off that gate. And boy, he sees people on the street. He sees people poor. You know what is going to happen to him? He's going to deny. He's going to say, oh no, that they are acting. Hello? He's going to say, no, that's not real. They are faking it. Oh, people, they're using costumes. Because in his palace, people costume to act place. They say, oh, that is just a costume. It's not real. Are you really poor? Are you really on the street? Are you really sick? Oh boy. It looks like the costume the actors in the palace use. Oh man. But let him dwell there for a long time. You are going to pray. Yes, your mother you love so much. Oh, my mother. Hush. Was she born again, spirit-filled? Did she know Christ before she gave birth to you? Was she a dynamic woman of prayer? Well, you know, my mother was a... Oh, yes. Oh, don't get me wrong. Mama is fine. Could that be that you are polluted already? Could it be there's a form of pollution? You've been the sanctuary of God. Those negative thoughts. Those sexual lusts. Those sexual thoughts. That pride. That anger. That rage. Oh, you're a sweetest pastor. But when you get angry, God help everybody around you. Oh, my God. Oh, yes. You're very, very nice. You're a nice, sweet person. I know you say it. Pastor, you know I'm a very sweet person. But when that demon comes staring you, that darkness, it means there's something inside of you that is occupied by the powers of darkness. There's a part of you that is still dark. There's a part of you that is occupied by the night. And we're going to pray this morning. The psalmist says, Lord, create in me a clean heart. Why? Because if the heart is darkened, if there's darkness in your heart, the powers of darkness and the spirit of the night has privileges. They have VIP pass. You know what they call VIP pass, people of God? You don't pass through security. VIP pass, you enter through the back door. Oh, yes, in the front. Oh, you are this. But there's something inside of you. Have you checked yourself? I know you've prayed, Lord, the blood of Jesus, I repent. Are you still struggling and battling with issues? Do you think the way God has positioned your life is that you should continuously, consistently, all the days of your life on this earth, go back and forth with these spiritual issues? Do you think that is God designed for you? It means no, there's still darkness in you that must go out. How? It goes out now. It by prayer, by fasting, by crying out to God, meditating upon the word of God, getting the light of God. The more light that is in you, the lesser the darkness. And a time comes when you are filled with the power of light, that all your body transfers light, your character transfers light, your heart transfers light. And everything about you, everything around you, everything that surrounds you become light. It becomes light. It becomes light. It becomes light. When it becomes light, you have power over darkness. Oh God, today I pray in the name of the Lord Jesus, every darkness still inside of my being, my Lord, you that called for light out of the darkness, I command light to come. Somebody pray with me this morning. I want you to begin to pray with me this morning. Yes, those of you on the live conference call, on the whatever you're watching, begin to open your mind and begin to pray against darkness. You don't want to continue living in darkness. Begin to pray. Bola baba santo baba shanta, back up every form of darkness in me. By the blood of Jesus, by the blood of Jesus, every false conception. Ah. Gotta be broken, it 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 gotta be broken. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, God wants to set you free. God wants to bring you free. You want to come out of that situation. God wants you out of that situation. God wants out of that situation. That the power of Christ may become a reality in you. Darkness. I know some of you say, well, you know, Pastor, it's your life. I'm going to pray for some of you today, because this is serious. And as we do this series, I want to make sure every day, those of you involved in darkness, you are gradually cleansed. You are on this line. I said again, you are on this line. You were told stories of your conception. You were told stories of who you were, how your mother got strange help to conceive you. I mean, there's a contract on you. There's an age on you. You're covenanted. In that movie, Spiritual Challenge, this young man was going to seminary to become a Catholic priest. When he was 22 years old, his father began to get the occult members to help him out. And they staged him. They got him expelled from the school. He got expelled. He was dejected. He began to stay on the street. His father's friends who were in the occult met him, took him home, took care of him. Before you know, at long last, they kidnapped him. Before you know, they forced him. He now joined the occult. He became wealthy. His father died. See, the devil does not keep his bargain. His father, with all his wealth, his father died. If you, from where I'm from, the devil can give you money. If it's money you're looking for, boy, he can give you money. You will have so much money, you don't know what to do with money. But it's for your life. I had an aunt of mine, one of my aunties. She's dead now. She died this year. She died of cancer. This year, she was married to one of the governors, the governor of Nigeria, one of the states in Nigeria. She was married to this governor, and this governor's mother is a strong Muslim. Yes, I said Muslim. The Muslim in Africa, they do voodoo. I don't know the Muslim others, but the Muslim in Nigeria, you can quote it. The Muslims in Nigeria, in Africa, mostly Nigeria, they do occultism. They consult witchcraft. They practice Islam. Most Africans are like that. They practice Christianity on one hand, and they have witchcraft on the other hand. They practice Islam on one hand, and they practice witchcraft on the other hand. They practice Buddha on one hand. They always miss it. An African, hardly does an African man serve one God. That is truly born again. And this aunt of mine, her mother-in-law, brought two turkeys, native Africa, wherever African, they call it a pigeon fowl. I don't know how to describe it. It's like turkey. It's not like turkey. It's like a fowl, like a chicken. And this chicken were at her backyard, at the governor's mansion. the governor's mansion. There were these two chickens there. And every time, and the mother-in-law says, don't kill this chicken, leave it there. But this chicken, they were feeding this chicken, and they become big and heavy. And the more they fed those chicken, the more sickling my aunt became. My aunt was sick and sick and sick. She was flown to America. And the worst thing, she didn't believe in deliverance. That's the worst thing. Oh, yes. We're deliverance ministers ordained by God. But she never believes in it. She's a Catholic. So the Catholic father, Catholics do believe in deliverance. But this father, Catholic father she goes to, doesn't believe in what we call charismatic Pentecostal deliverance. He believes that no, he can handle it. He doesn't have the wisdom of what he was dealing with. So one of our uncles went and looked for some pastors to come and pray. When they came to the compound, they began to dig stuff buried in that compound that was making us sick. And the Holy Ghost told them those two chickens should be killed. The minute they killed those two chickens, my aunt recovered. She got almost better, but she still did not come for deliverance. And the lady again, the mother-in-law, went into a deeper level of witchcraft. And the cancer spread. So my aunt died. And that's the end of her life. She's gone. Done with. Now, what am I trying to tell you? So you find in this movie, this guy became 23 years old, very wealthy. But the condition was that he should never see his mother's face again. So when he left home at 22, when he got into the orchard, his father's orchard, because they told the father, we give you this child belongs to us. The condition they placed on him, this young man, was you will never see your mother's face. The day you see your mother face to face, that day you will die. And the fetish high priest said something that's so real. He said, ignorance is not an excuse. And with this demonic God, there's no forgiveness. And that's the reality. The devil does not forgive. The devil does not, it's not a concept of the devil to forgive, to walk in love. He doesn't understand that. So one day, this young business guru was looking for a bigger house to buy. And lo and behold, he went to his mother's friend. He never knew that was his mother's best friend's villa he wants to buy. And the mother was in that house. The mother came out and saw him. He saw his mother. He screamed, my mother, oh, I'm going to die. I've been in the occult that my father put me before I was born. I was not meant to see you face. The mother said, what? Right there. He died and disappeared. The occult took him. Well, what am I trying to tell you this morning? You need to come out of darkness. You need to come out of darkness into the light of God. There are powers of darkness. As you approach a new calendar beginning, as you approach a new era in your life, there are certain things you don't want to take to the next level with your glory. We're going to pray again. You're on this line. Your father was in the occult. Your mother was in the occult. Press 5-star. I'm going to open your line. You're going to tell me things. I'm going to pray with you. Right now. I'm not joking. I'm not playing with you on that level. On this line. Father is in the occult. Mother is in the occult. You were born out of such homes. When you were a child, your mother told you she had to drink this to protect you. She went to places to get you. There's a time on your head. Tell her I said so. Tell her a man of God says, Mama, what you've done, it means there's something on my head. that if I don't deal with it, it will take my life. I will not live long like you've lived long. Oh yeah, the success you've accomplished. Boy, what covenant was signed with you? What covenant was signed with you? What covenant was signed with you? God! God is able to deliver you. Five and the star key. I want to pray with you. So I want to pray with some of you this morning. Five and the star key. Five star on your phone. I want to open your line. I want to pray with you. You need that prayer. Oh, yes. It's up to you. I said this whole series. It's going to be a super deliverance prayer week all through before the new calendar begins. I want to make sure we dealt with some things in you that I don't want you to carry forward. Yes. Yes. Five and the star key. I'm talking about you. Where did they go? What did they do for you? How? How? Well, you can choose to hide on it. You can choose to say, well, you know, I don't know. Let me just keep quiet because, you know, Now, listen very well. I'm not going to call your name. I'm going to call your phone number. And I'm not going to call all your phone number. I'm going to call the first 6 digit of your phone number. So you should know your phone number very well. And when I open your line, don't tell me your name. Just say, Pastor, yes, this is what happened. This is what I know. This is what they did. This is what they don't do. My father was this. And we're going to pray. You see, truth will set you free. Truth. There was a lady. She was looking for the fruit of the womb. She needed the fruit of the womb so bad. She went to a herbalist. And the herbalist told her, all right, get 2-3 eggs, go naked in the forest. This is the time. And after a few months, you get pregnant, you have girls, and this and that. You have. And she said, yes, I will do. And she went with the husband. Both of them went, and they got twins. But the voodoo priest did not tell them the consequence. And after she got pregnant, she became a Christian. Oh, she became a woman of prayer. The man became a leader in the church. They were prayerful people. But they forgot 20 years ago that the children did not have. You can't cheat the system. You are not smart enough. You didn't hear what I said. You are not smart enough. They sent those children to the best school, private schools. From young age, they went to private schools. Expensive stuff. Went overseas. Did everything. Pampered them. The man was wealthy. He became even much more wealthy when he had those children. Then one day they became sick. From sickness to sickness to sickness, from one prayer room, one prayer ministry to one prayer to one fasting and one fasting. Why are you fasting when you know that the way you got the child is not of God? Why are you making those pastors work so hard? Why don't you come out of darkness? What's wrong with you? Oh, begin to give offering, prayer. This has to happen. This, they became sick, they got sick, yeah, they were sick. And one hospital, all the monies began to go, all the wealth began to go to pay bills, health bills, insurance bills began to pay. They were sick and sick and sick and sick until the man got bankrupt, no more money. They became sick until the man sold all he had, became sick, and later the children died. And he was disrupted. He was broken Ah, he prayed. Why did they die? He fasted. Why did they die? He prayed. Just like David. David took the wrong seed, killed somebody, took his wife, and had a child. David was fasting and praying for the child not to die, and the child died. God says, no, I can't bless what I did not give you. Then the Holy Ghost remembered this man and the wife, what they did before they became Christians to get those children, those two girls, twins. Twins. They died in their 20s. Because they were not from God, they were from the spirit world. Marine powers. Powers of darkness. Spirit of the night. It was at night. They go to the stream to take their bath. It was at night. They gave their sacrifice. It was at night. Children of the night. They will wreck you. I'm going to pray for some of you this morning. I'm talking to somebody here this morning. This is your day of deliverance. This is your day of transformation. How long do you want to live your life like that? How long do you want to live your life like that? How long do you want to live your life like that? Have you discovered why you are having challenges? Why you are having problems? Why it seems nothing is working for you when it comes to you? It's one thing after the other. Haven't you discovered that there's something fishy about your life? Oh yes, you pray. You pray. That's why you need to pray more. You need to cry to God. Let it be total and complete deliverance. Whatever was done to tie you in. Whatever aid. That's the contention. You can't change God's viewpoint. You were just born yesterday. You're not even 100 years old. These things have been there since creation. From beginning of time. In the beginning, there was water and darkness. Who are you? You were just born yesterday. Your whole year is not even up to a minute in the sight of God. You think you can change what has been there? Yes, you can. With repentance. With the blood of Jesus. Yes, you can. By yielding yourself to God. And say, Lord, I don't know. I didn't do it, Lord. I didn't know what it did to me. But here I am. Let my spirit be saved. If my body decay, if I die tomorrow, if the covenant was signed, but let my spirit, let me know that I heard the gospel, then I was able to change. But God, if you break it well for me. If you're breaking it, do it well. Go all the way. Go all the way. We're going to pray with you. There's so many mysteries that I don't know about. So many deep things that I myself don't even understand. But the word of God is clear. God wants to help you. You're an apostle now. You're a bishop now. So you think, well, you know, those things, sorry. Because the enemy has a VIP pass to your life. He's just waiting. He has not started yet. He's just waiting for the right time. Because he has his own calendar. Spirit don't die. Spirits don't die. There's no age. Spirits are not moved by blood. They don't have flesh and blood in them. So there's no timeline. They don't grow old. They are not babies to grow and retire. They exist until judgment in hell. That's what demon spirit and spiritual things are. There's no time frame. There's no today. There's no Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday to the spirit world. I want to pray with you this morning. I want to lift you up before God. I want to take your prayers one after one. And I said again, whatever is shared here, whatever is discussed here, it's it's not for you. If you know the person, say, oh, I never knew this was on you. Nope, nope, nope. And if you are married, if you are married, you are married, you are married. You are married and your husband is on this line listening, or your wife is listening. Don't say anything. Call me privately. Oh yes, I know some of you go, but why? No, 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 because some of you, you are very immature. You're immature. You're not grown. You begin to use it as a yardstick. You begin to look for a scapegoat. Maryland, 240551. Good morning. Talk to me. Why do you need this prayer this morning? Why do you need prayer? Talk to me. Yes, good morning. Talk to me. Why do you need this? Yes, why do you need this prayer this morning? No, no, it's not about the slave. Are you part of that? Were you conceived? I want someone to help me with the sister there. I need someone that can speak very clear English to help me explain that issue right there. Is any of your children home? Who is home? Is Owen home?
Yes, Pastor.
Okay. What you need to do, you need to call me later. Call me later. Call me later. I need to hear your story very well, so I'll clearly understand it, so I'll pray with you effectively. The line is not clear right now. All right. 704-704-4317. Good morning.
Good morning, Pastor Wallace.
Wonderful, wonderful. Talk to me.
Yeah, I like everything I told you before. For my mom who conceived me, she's been having kids and been dying. And I was the third one. And she said, oh, mother, I have to carry her somewhere. It was on 9 minutes old. The same day she told me, I told her, I said, I need delivery because my unit is transferred. She said, that's why I don't need it. I need delivery in my spiritual life.
You need it.
Because of that, I dream, I see my thing, Africa,
Yeah, you need deliverance. For you, your deliverance is going to be an ongoing thing. And I'm coming to North Carolina. Let's talk. I'm coming January 4th. I'll be there for like 3 days. We need to meet if it's possible, please. All right? I'm going to make time for you as well again this new year. You need it. You need it. I keep on saying it. Yours, I know your station. And we're going to pray. Father, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, we lift up your daughter before you. We want to thank you, Father God, because your power is available for deliverance. Today, whatever her mother drank to hold her in that womb, whatever water her mother took a bath, people of God, you are going to pray as though this is your daughter, this is your sister. This is my sister. I've known her for 7 years, maybe 6 years, not 7 years. She's one of the oldest friends we have in this country. She's one of my oldest friends. We're going to cry to God because not only this one, every other one from that womb, that's how it goes. It contaminates the whole womb. It's not only this one. Every other child that has come out of that womb is bound and held by some powers. Babdole, begin to pray. We cry to God. Father, let there be deliverance. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, we repent, oh God. We repent, oh God, for the sins of mama. We repent, oh God, for the sins of ignorance. We cry. Somebody pray with me this morning. Pray, pray. Lift up your voice and cry with us. Cry with us. Let's pray. These are realities. Father, we cry out to you. that you will show us mercy. That you will show us mercy. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, we cry out to you this morning. We are saying, God, arise and make your power known. We are saying, God, arise and make your wisdom known. We are saying, God, bring forth deliverance in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Every arrangement, every agreement, every part of the enemy, that which the enemy has conspired. Jehovah.